I will talk about universal forgery and recovery attacks on ELM dot amp-safe encryption function algorithm. It's a joint work with Oğuzhan Ersoy and Ferhat Karakoç. This is the outline of my talk. First, I will give a brief background about authenticated encryption and specification of the algorithm ELMD. Then I will mention our work, criteria of ELMD. Then I will conclude my talk. As we all know, the oldest cryptography is known as encryption, which provides confidentiality. And due to the other needs, the other notions have appeared, like message authentication, which provides data origin authentication. And in many applications with encryption, you have always, most of the time, you have message authentication also needed. We cannot think of them separately. Here, that is, in on one hand, we have an encryption scheme which provides confidentiality. On the other hand, we have a message authentication code which provides authenticity. And in the middle, we need an algorithm which provides achieve both confidentiality and authenticity. For many years, authenticated encryption schemes were proposed, but due to security, many of them have security flaws and maybe implementation flaws. Because of this, crypto community came together to announce Quasar Computation, which is short for Computation for Authenticated Encryption, Security, Applicability, and Robustness. And the aim is to identify the portfolio of authenticated ciphers that offer advantage over AES GSM, authenticated mode of AES, and it's suitable for widespread adoption. Now the competition is on the third round, and it will be the announcement of the winner will be 2017 expected the next year. And the submissions are categorized according to the base algorithms, block cipher, string cipher, and others. And our target cipher is a block cipher base. ELMD is proposed by Data and Nandi for Quasar Computation. Now it's the third round Quasar candidate. It processes messages in the encrypt mix in the decrypt paradigm. It accepts associated data. It is online. That means that ICE ciphertext is only depends on previous ICE plaintext, and it's parallelizable. In order to mix the branches in the algorithm, row function is defined. It takes two inputs X and T, and outputs Y and T prime. Y is equal to X XOR 3 times T. T is updated to T prime X XOR 2 times T, and the multiplication is here is done in a Galois. The message padding rule let N be the message of L blocks, and the last block can be incomplete. In the submitted version, the padding, if the last block was is incomplete, there will be 1-0 padding. Otherwise, we keep it itself. And there is an extra message block, which is for a tag generation, ML plus 1. It will be the XOR of all previous messages. And but in the and they provide modified version in order to increase the security. Here, they added the all previous messages to ML here in both case. ML plus 1 will be again ML. My hair. Parameters of ELMD, as I said, it's block cipher based, and AES 128 is used in either 6 or 10 rounds. Also, there is provisions of intermediate tech, in order to fasten decryption and verification. Also, there is an internal parameter mask, which is secret in the algorithm. This is generated by encryption of zero. If it is 10 rounds, it's just one encryption. If it is 6 rounds, yes, it will be twice encryption. In order to, in order to generate initial value for encryption algorithm and decryption algorithm, associated data is processed. Let the first associated data be the public number, which is unique for each encryption, and parameters will be the first associated data always exists, and the others will be D1 up to DD, and there will be again padding if it is incomplete. The processing is here. There will be zero in the beginning, and the zero will be masked with 3L. L is an internal mask we generate before. This is AES six rounds or 10 rounds. It depends on the choice, and the output will be mixed with the raw function, and this this will continue until all associated data finishes in order to generate the initial value. Here, there is one difference. If the last block is incomplete, there will be the masking rule will be changed. This is important in our attacks. Encryption function. This is in fact the encryption itself. There will be IV, and the message will be M1, M2, and up to ML. This is padded message, and the first message will be masked and will be encrypted, and the resulting value will be mixed with a raw function, and there is decryption here, decryption of 6 or 10 rounds AES. It's either 6-6 or 10-10, and there will be masking again in order to generate the ciphertext. It is the same until the last block. For the last block, there is one bit difference added, one bit difference added here. Also, same with associated data. If the last block is incomplete, ML star, the masking rule is different in the last two blocks. Other blocks are the same. For decryption, first IV is generated in the same way, and the encryption function will be reversed in order to generate the messages. But the plaintexts are released if the last two plaintexts are equal. Otherwise, nothing will be released. For the security claims, authors claim that for confidentiality and integrity, there are 62-bit security. But for the key recovery attacks, without providing any proof, they said that the algorithm has 128-bit security against key recovery attacks. And we disprove this claim by providing successful attack on ALMD 6.6, only one version. First, we need to recover internal state L. Let me remind you, L was generated either in twice encryption of zero or encryption of zero, if it is 10. As we see from the algorithms, it's used to mask associated data, plaintext, and ciphertext. By making collision search on ciphertext, we can deduce this internal state L, and this L helps to make forgery and key recovery attacks for the cipher. We use the different masking if the rule of different masking if the associated data is different, has different length. Here we get two set of for fixed D0, two set of messages, alpha M and beta M. Alpha and beta are associated data here. M the message, we have the same message. And alpha is incomplete and beta is a complete block. So there are differences in masking here. We search collision on the first plain text, on the first ciphertext, sorry. If we have a collision, we go back and we see that this message are equal. We have a collision here, IVs are equal. So since these zero are chosen as the same, we have a same internal value here. So we are, everything is equal until here. So this equality means that mask value of associated data are equal. So we have this equality. Since we know D1 and D1 prime, and we don't know L, we can compute L here with complex, with birthday complexity. Now we know L, we can make, there are several fraudulent attacks we can make, but I just give one example. First, assume that we have a message, target message. We want to find its ciphertext and attack. First, it has D0 and D. This D can be any length, and message M. First, here we query associated data D0, and we query message after masking, their values are equal. I mean, the encryption of this mask D0 and encryption of mask message are equal. So here, due to the, we have IV here, and we have another same value here. After row function, we have two IV here. So what we have, due to the structure of the algorithm, this mask ciphertext, encryption of this mask ciphertext is equal to two IV. So what are we going to do with this? We can make internal state here zero by choosing this this ciphertext as an associated data. So we have IV here, zero comes here, two IV, and we have zero. And we can, if we choose D2 is as D0, and these are arranged masking values. So if you don't think of mask, D0 and D2 are equal, and we have the same IV here. So if we query the oracle different associated data with D and the message M, we will have the ciphertext and tag, which is also valid for this target message. Also, we exploit two types of plaintext pairs for AES. In the algorithm, we can generate mu multiplicative pairs for AES. This is for any plaintext and for any constant in the Galois field. We can find another plaintext P2, which is encryption is mu times encryption of P1. We can generate this from algorithm. Also, we can have one difference pairs, which means that we can have two plaintexts. Their encryption differs in the least significant bit. And by using these two in the algorithm, we can query any ciphertext to the decryption mode of the AES cipher. In fact, we can find any plaintext of given ciphertext. First, we find two multiplicative pairs, which means that we have one for any plaintext R1. We find another plaintext satisfying this property. Here, again, in the forgery attack, we use this plaintext, which is encryption is 2IV. Then we again use this to make IV to the encryption function is zero. So we take two messages, which is mask values are the same. Here the same encryption of R1, same encryption of R1. We have two encryption R1. So if we go backward, this mask ciphertext, we call it R2, and the encryption of R2 is two times encryption of R1. And by using this pair, we can also make it for any constant. Assume that we have a pair P1 and R2. They are two multiplicative. And we have 190 blocks encryption, and each plaintext. Now, since we know L, so I will just starting from mask after mask in order to not to be confused. We have M1 and R, P1 or R2 in every block. Here, this means that if we have P1, this is encryption of P1. If we have R2, this is 2 times encryption of P1. And here, there will be M1 encryption of P1. Here, M2 encryption of P1. And we due to the row function, we have 2M1 encryption of P1 XOR M2 encryption of P1. Until here, we have mu times encryption of P1. In the last block, we choose the message as P1. And here we have the encryption of P2, which is mask ciphertext, will be the mu times encryption of P1. So here we can generate this. We have these pairs. Also, we can generate one difference pair. As I said before, their encryption differs in the least significant bit. Assume that we have two multiplicative pairs. One is used here. You can use the same as well. One is to make IV 0, and the other will be for the messages. B, we have 2B, and B, 2B makes this 0. So the last message, this is the tag generation phase, and will be the encryption of P1 and P2. This is M3. And the encryption, we said R1. Encryption of R1 comes here due to this 0, and the encryption of R2, this is mask ciphertext, will differ in the least significant bit. So we can also find here. Now, how can we query the encryption oracle of AES inside LMD? First, we take a pair, we get a pair which is their encryption differ in 1 bit. And we obtain plain text R3 for R1, satisfying this property, because this is mu, and for every R1 we can find, for every view we can find a plain text. So we query the oracle by choosing associated data, making IV0. We can do it, we did it before. And for the first message we have R3. And for the second message, we have R2. Here we have encryption of R3. Since this is 0, this comes here. And there will be encryption of R2. And after row function, we have 3 encryption of R3 and encryption of R1, which is, this is due to this equality, this is encryption of R1. And we know that their encryption is, their XOR is 1, so we have a plain text, since there is inverse, we have a plain text whose encryption is 1. So by using mu multiplicative pairs, we by picking ciphertext mu, we can find another, we can find a plain text which is encryption is mu. So we can, in this way, we can query the decryption oracle of AES. And this complexity is generating mu multiplicative pair, which is around 2^8 encryption of operation of AES. So now we can query, we have chosen plain text, chosen ciphertext, so we can make attack on 6-round AES. We choose 2 attack, one is partial sum attack, and the other one Demirci Selçuk meet in the middle attack. In this partial sum attack, the time complexity is 2^44, and the data complex is 2^34, the total complex, but the total time complexity will be dominated by finding internal state L, which is a collision search. So this is around 2^65, this attack for ALMD, for key recovery attack. But this attack was chosen plain text. We have chosen ciphertext, but it's not hard to adapt the attack to the chosen ciphertext because of AES structure. We also propose the Demirci Selçuk meet in the middle attack with less data complexity, but a bit bigger time complexity, and the total complexity is 2^66. There was, as far as we know, there is only one analysis of LMD, which was proposed by Zhang and Wu in terms of both authenticity and privacy. For authenticity, they provide successful forgeries, but for the privacy, they attack on reduced version of LMD. In fact, they use four round AES inside the cipher, and they consider L as encryption of zero with four rounds. But the complexity of attack 2 to the 123, this is huge. But if you consider this, and you can make a meet-in-the-middle attack to find the key, so you don't need to make effort on this. Also, this 4 and 4 is not in the proposal of LMD. So to conclude, our attack was the first cryptonyms of full-round LMD, and we disproved the security claim such that we reduced the security of one version, 6.6 version of LMD from 128 to 65 bits. And we are expecting that they should remove this version from the proposal. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?
So, do you have any question?
They are similar.
So the current candidate's cipher is
COLM. COLM, yeah.
Yeah, so what do you think is the security of COLM?
Yeah, in fact, COLM is a mix of ALMD and COPPA. Here in this attack, in fact, we exploit the structure of encrypt and decrypt case. But for COLM, there's encrypt and encrypt. Also, they consider AES only 10 rounds, so we this attack is not applied.
Okay, thank you very much. So, do you have any questions?